To heal the contrite of hearts. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to cause sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of God the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, Almighty Father, our faith professes that your Son died and rose again. Mercifully grant that to this mystery, your servant, Triumphs and angels who have fallen asleep in Christ may rejoice to rise again through him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Himself, and he has given him authority to because he is the Son of Man. Do not be astonished at this, for the hour is coming, when all who are in their graves will hear his voice and will come out, those who have done good, to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil, to the resurrection of condemnation. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Tears and envy as well. But other human beings, you and I, we have to make it very clear. One day we will die. That's it. If we have that in mind, we don't have to be angry at what? That's the nature of death. Because it seems yet in. That's why we have to face death. But luckily for us, and fortunately for us, that God spares deliberately. Doesn't matter. You have life with me. Eternal life with me. Well, I don't know what else you can be needed. That's why many people find circle around to find the answer. And I was one of them as well. When I studied theology or philosophy or psychology, I also should allow what eternal life is about. And I will dig deeper to find the meaning of life and the meaning of eternal life. Like all young people, of course, in your brain, in your thinking, you think, oh, not just a joke. I better, I have a way for my life. But after you take time to dig it in, you see, oh my gosh, there's a big hole there. Big gap there for you and I to reach God. So everything we do, anything God just has advantage, just believe. Just believe in Him and let Him take care of everything. If we have that in order, we don't have to be angry. Don't have to be worried and even sad, because it's a part of life. But for those who do not prepare for that, or think about that, because if they think they better, they would be in trouble. Because of the scriptures today, they are very clear. God loved us so much that He sent His only Son to be with us and to redeem us. He brings the eternal life back for us. But He the fair judge, fair God. Anyone who do good things will get the eternal life. Anything else will get the resurrection of condemnation. So let it be that way for God. The only thing you and I will look at the mercy of God. That's why people just say, wait for the last minute and call the Father, and everything will be fine. Well, I am not guarantee of that. Because we don't want to play that kind of games. We don't know. God will look differently. So, again, we have to be prepared. One way or another, oh, because I don't need God now. The church doesn't matter, but it's not. It's very much. Who will be saving you? Or me? We have to do it ourselves first. If you neglect that, if you think that we are the super already, we don't blame at God. Because our God is a God of church, but with mercy. Then that's why people said, Father, what the point of going to Mass every day for? The day you go to the Mass every day, you earn it. you will dare go. Because when you listen to his words and you apply them into your lives, and also one person asked me, in case, if no resurrection, so if when I'm going to Mass for 90 years, it in vain. I answered that back, I rather get in vain than risk the another way, risky way. So, it made very clear to us. So today we are facing with the two souls here. And again, one very young, the angels. And the other one, the adults, also a young man too. And again, into their lives, God knows. The only thing we are given with the family to pray that, with his mercy and love, you bring these innocent souls be with him. But in our heart, we remind us that we one day, we face it. That's why King Louis of France, you know, he built a tomb in his palace. He had a tomb in the front of his palace. And each morning when he wake up, he looked at that empty tomb. And to remind him that Louis, one day you will be in that tomb. Remind him every day, that's why he become the favorite king of France. I don't have a tomb, but not my rectory. But I can see the crucifix there. I said to myself, one day I will be somewhere, someplace. So something to remind us. My dear brothers and sisters, don't be afraid. Don't be afraid. Life and death is in the hands of God. The only thing is if you and I be well prepared and well believed in our words, I think we are saved. God and take all this. Whatever our words said in the gospel and the readings we have in the scriptures, that reminds us. So may the soul of Brian and angels to be at peace with God. And also, God will continue to bless the child's family at their mourning for their loved ones as well. So, be a part of our community here, okay? I think you new here, and I welcome dearly. And also, get them to the prayer for the school here. Be a part of our community as well. Okay? We are open for you and your family.
Forever and ever.
Amen.
Trusting in God, we have prayed together for friends and angels. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we may take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see friends and angels again and enjoy their friendships. Although this congregation will disperse with sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the face of our Lord Jesus Christ. In baptism, friends and angels share in the death and resurrection of Christ. May they be welcomed into the glory of eternal life.
praise to God, who hath called them to share in his glory. Now let us pray together as Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us.
Let us pray. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Brian and angels in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, they will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestow upon Christ and angels in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise for your servants and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith, until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother and sister forever and ever.
Amen.
My dear friends, may every mark of affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peaceful